What is good, my anime people? What is good, yo? Guys, I have seen Delight, and excuse me. Obviously, for weird reasons, Fate Zero. It's just, or I don't know why I just call it Fate Zero. Fate Grand Order is doing some weird stuff, in my opinion, when it comes down to its recruiting regiments. Sure, using goddesses and supposedly having someone flirt with them, or at least making them feel important in some way, shape, or form, would make anybody, kind of down to protect or take care of them. But these attempts, or like these ways of getting them, were kind of lackluster. But to be fair, you can't really question how their characters are if this is just how they are, right? Like, imagine the same situation if our main character did this to Mash, right? If he does this to Mash, it happens. It works the same way, but he would do it a little bit differently. It's not too unconventional for this world, because we know what the heck a lot of these servants could have possibly gone through. And I'm saying we know, because I know there's like the fan base out there that has gone through and through, reading and learning as much as they can, about the characters they really enjoy. And I apologize, I'm getting like a sore throat. I don't know where it's coming from, but I keep clearing my throat so I'm not coughing in your guys' ears. I do apologize for even clearing my throat like that. That's annoying. But to know all the information about these characters and go in watching it like that must be much more, in the case of what we're seeing, it must feel pretty good to know there's something amiss about everything. Like, okay, so here's the thing. The Jaguar person, we get as much information that they want to give us, and then they just write them off, write her off as our teammate, and that's it, right? Like, that's about as far as it goes. Like, we know she had some, she was gathering up sacrificial people, which it looks like it turns out she wasn't really getting, the best of the best of her own temple. So it looks like she was working more or less just for the Sun Goddess and all those people that she happened to show up at the kingdom to grab before running off were all still alive. And for some reason, some dude that got like thrown, like when she first shows up and she's just flexing and stuff, she straight up was juggling three people, and then she just lunges all of them towards, our main characters, and somehow all three of those guys survive, which is ridiculous to me. to think that, this is just this type of world where she put something on them called Killer Blow, like Killer Revive, excuse me. So even if she hits you with the Killing Blow, you revive on the spot, like later on, maybe when she w wishes. I missed that part. If it is like instantaneous, like once they were put in that box, how long from, from then to when they got to the temple did it take them to wake up? And they all relatively seem like they're all up, like no one's still unconscious or something like that. So it's a really interesting concept that they went with, just with, of course, not only this goddess, but for a goddess that is relatively a well-known fact of, or not a fact, but a well-known talked about aspect of history in classes and stuff like that, being the Aztecs and just what they actually did when they were in their reign and stuff like that, which always interests me how we got like that information and like who was there to actually state that this was all facts, witnessed it, and wasn't, actually sacrificed and for some reason gave us this knowledge. But overall, I'm looking so forward to what Fate Grand Order has been kind of laying down. I mean, I'm not too happy how fast we got Jaguar on our team. It was just like, well, here you go. You're not going to be able to win anyway. So here you go. Just take her. I understand that the main reason why she was probably so thrown off at the approach compared to all the other approaches, all times they have she's approached, she's taken the spotlight. She's been noticed. Next thing you know, they're walking in the forest. They absolutely play her no mind, having her like run back in front of them two or three times and start breaking down crying before they actually pay attention to her. And then instead of fighting like they always do, he starts, flirting with her and like not even really flirting with her because all the girls were pretty, well, Mash and Anne were pretty disappointed in our boy. So I'm kind of glad they were because all he did was just talk about factual things and then try to throw something as a compliment in it. So absolutely weird episode with how they went about getting her. I'm guessing she's more of just a gag character for now or throughout this whole thing because as of the last time we seen her, she seemed like an actual threat, and this week's episode completely neutralized any thought of that. But I guess we could say the same thing at, well, not so much. We couldn't say this so much about the Arrow Girl or the girl that's, the goddess that's joined us before her, because simply it didn't feel like she was just a wild cannon, She's like, I'm no one's ally. I'm me. Or, she's like, I am on the goddess's side, but I'm not gonna do their biddings this day. It's like, oh, okay. Cool. You're a free spirit. Do what you want. So I'm looking forward to seeing what you guys have to say about this. And I picked Spawn because I was thinking, what would be a six servant to hire? It would be Spawn if he ever got stuck in this. But I don't know if anyone even made it to this far of the video to hear me say that because, we all have our reasons for things. But my anime people, I will be dropping Sword Art and the show that everybody should be watching the video soon. So make sure you're looking forward to that. If you are, keep your ears and eyes out for the channel. And I do want to say, have an awesome day, night, evening, and I will talk to you in the next one. So with that being said, take care. I'm looking forward to tomorrow as well. There's so much stuff coming close to ends that means there's new beginnings always in anime. So either that's really scary for me or a good thing, 'cause your boy about to be either more busy than he's been for this whole entire like month and last month, or I might be getting a break and we might get slowed down. But sounds like Dragon Ball might be on the horizon, and let's see how that plays out. With all that being said, peace. Why isn't he doing anything? Oh, God. I was joking. Don't do anything. Stop doing stuff. Who told you to do stuff? I soul edged. I try to grab, I swear. Delete that out of your memory.